Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the first part of this beginner's guide to hand painting your first kit. A bit of a background first. A few months back, I had done a couple of beginner guide videos using an airbrush. Though the series got a lot of views, many viewers also complained that they had been expecting me to hand paint the kit. They argued that real beginners don't have compressors and airbrushes. It was a valid point, and I had to agree. And so, I hand painted this kit and hope this will help many fellow modelers who are starting out in this wonderful hobby. Also, apart from hand painting, I will share with you some beginner's tips, as well as show you some tools and equipment that you may want to invest in as you start off. For this series, I chose this Academy 1/72 scale P47. It's a nicely molded 72 scale kit with good surface detail. But the reason I chose this kit is because of this simple paint scheme option in dark green. There are only three main colors and there is no camouflage pattern. I would recommend that as a beginner, you start with a similar kit that allows you to focus on your technique rather than getting overwhelmed with detailed paint schemes and multiple masking and so forth. Well, without any further delay, let's get on with it. First, let me introduce you to what is arguably the most versatile and important tool for a modeler, the hobby knife. Now, these come in various shapes, sizes, and material, but finding one that you like is of utmost importance. Also, I would suggest that even if you are on a budget, a good hobby knife is something that you should invest in. When I started out, I used my hobby knife for everything, like cutting pieces of the sprue. If you have a sharp blade, it is very easy to make clean cuts. Also, the knife can be used to clean up the parts that you have just cut. As you move further in the hobby, you may want to buy a pair of sprue cutters, like these ones. They make cutting pieces and plastic a little quicker and easier than a hobby knife. Once again, these come in many shapes and sizes. Just make sure that should you buy one, choose one that has blades that line up against each other, rather than overlap like a pair of scissors. While using the side cutter, make sure you cut away from the piece. No matter how sharp the cutters are, there will be some amount of pinching of plastic when they cut, and it is best that any pinching or distortion to the plastic happens well away from the piece. Once the piece is cut loose, you can simply clean it up with your hobby knife. Also, when it comes to smaller, more delicate pieces, it is best that you use the hobby knife only. A side cutter can easily break a delicate piece. I have now cut and cleaned all the pieces for the cockpit and am ready to paint them. While dealing with multiple small parts, I usually stick them to little balls of this stuff, blue tack. This makes handling them very easy. Also, you do not have to touch the piece with your fingers, avoiding any nasty fingerprints all over it. Blue tack is very cheap and I suggest you buy some. Now, before we start painting, let me show you the brushes I will be using. The first brush is a flat, soft synthetic fiber brush that I will be using for applying paint in wide areas. This rounded brush will be used to apply paint in narrower areas. Also, a similar rounded brush will be used later to blend oil paints when the time comes. I have another narrow flat brush for dry brushing, a technique I will explain later. And some fine tip brushes to paint details. Now, almost all kit instructions come with a color callout, indicating which colors the kit maker suggests you use. As a beginner, I would suggest not to get bogged down with finding the perfect color or the exact color suggested in the instructions. What I would suggest you do is simply do a quick search on the net and find pictures of the aircraft you are painting. From there, just find the closest color that you can find to the one shown in the pictures. I happen to have this zinc chrome from Vallejo with me. I will be using this paint for the cockpit interior. Just one piece of advice. Use water-based or acrylic paints to start with. You can paint with lacquer paints or other types of paints, but hand painting with them is a little trickier than water-based paints. So to start with, any water-based paint should do. And you can then build from there as you gain experience. A very important part of painting by hand is getting the consistency of the paint right. As you can see, I am diluting this paint with water by almost 50%. What I am looking for is paint that gives coverage but is runny enough to self-level itself. If the paint is too thick, it will hold brush strokes, which we don't want. Watering down the paint will mean applying multiple layers, but because the paint is runny, it will not hold brush strokes and will level out, giving a smoother finish. Now to apply the paint. I apply a single layer of paint and then leave it to self-level. Do not fiddle with the paint once applied. As the paint dries, it will start holding brush strokes. So even if the paint does not appear even on the first application, or there are parts where you can see the plastic show through, just leave it alone. All you need to be focused on is making sure that whatever paint you have applied to the piece is allowed to level itself. The only two things that you need to guard against are bubbles, which you must not allow to dry, and pooling of the paint, which often happens in joints and bends, like here on the seat. I simply remove paint from the brush and suck up the extra paint from the seat. In this case, I applied a total of 6 layers of watered down green paint till I was satisfied with the result. Also, I like the parts to have some variation in color depth, which I think makes it look more realistic than a coat of flat even paint. After the 6th layer had dried, I painted the control panel black and also hand painted some details inside the cockpit. Some parts are painted black, while others are painted white. I also paint some buttons and knobs with red and yellow color. This is not accurate, but I don't think that at this point in your hobby, you should be obsessed with being absolutely correct about every dab of paint you apply. Just make sure that the overall look of the kit is realistic. To bring out details on some parts like this control panel, we will be using a technique called dry brushing. I first take a relatively stiff flat brush and apply paint to it. I am using Citadel's Necro Compound, but you can use any metallic color from aluminium to silver. Now I remove almost all paint from the brush by rubbing it off onto a piece of paper. Remember, remove as much paint as possible from the brush. Don't worry, there will be enough left for this technique to work. Now I brush the raised features on the control panel. What this technique does is that the raised features of the piece slowly pick up the paint, while the base below the features remains in the original color. With all the paint now dry, I will protect the work done so far by brushing on a couple of layers of varnish and allowing it to dry. To show wear and tear inside the cockpit, I will now add some chipping using a sponge. I tear a piece of common sponge. I dip this sponge in metallic paint and then remove most of the paint from it. The sponge is then used to gently dab the cockpit pieces. This adds tiny chipping to the piece. The last effect we are going to add to the cockpit is a wash. The wash will further dirty up the inside and add some shadows to the features. Now, while many ready-made washes are available, I will mix up a simple one with black oil paint and some turpentine. You can also use odorless spirit for this, which is actually a little better than turpentine. When the mix is really runny, I apply it to the parts. Once the wash is dry to touch, I remove the extra wash with a Q-tip moistened with turpentine. Right then, fellow model makers, that about does it for painting the cockpit. Next time, we will put the kit together and start off with the painting. I hope you liked the first edition of this beginner's guide. If you did, please do leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till next time, good luck and happy model making.